Hey everybody, it's Eric from epautos.com, your libertarian car guy, and it's time for an early morning rant on my way to the gym. Some of you may have heard the announcement that two Chinese car companies have signed franchising dealer deals with some American distributors to sell their models in the United States. So far, they are Zotye Motors and GAC. Somewhat cumbersome, not very sexy to pronounce, but at any rate, those are apparently the first two Chinese car companies that are going to be selling some cars in this country, beginning with the 2020 model year. Now, I had high hopes for all of this because I thought that the Chinese might restore some sanity to the American car market by bringing some lower cost, simpler vehicles to the market. There's a dearth of such cars on the market right now, one of the few being the new Mitsubishi Mirage that I reviewed last week. But other than it and a handful of others, there's really not that much in the price range of around $13,000 to $15,000 bucks or so. Whereas in China, you can get cars that cost $10,000 or less, and these are not latter-day versions of the Pinto or the Chevette. In fact, they have air conditioning, they've got power windows and locks, they've even got LCD touchscreens. They have airbags, but only two, not six, and they would pass all of the safety mandates, probably, that were in place in this country through up to the probably late 1990s or 2000s, but that's neither here nor there, because in my opinion, safety is none of the government's business in a free society, as I've ranted about before, because we're not talking about whether the car is not roadworthy or unsafe to drive. We're simply talking about whether it conforms to all of the various crash test standards that are in place. It does not mean that the car is more likely to crash at all. It just means that if you do crash, the structure of the car can't absorb the same amount of impact as the government-approved car. So pretty much every car that was manufactured, let's say in 1980, would not meet current safety standards, and in 1980 every car on the road was not unsafe. They were just more or less crash-worthy relative to the government's standards. So for that reason chiefly, we can't have those cars. The cars do pass, or could pass, probably, the emissions tests that are applicable here, and I'm not going to make an argument against those. As a libertarian, I think that you don't have the right to cause damage to another person or their property, and you can make a legitimate argument that emissions that are objectively harmful, that can be proved to be harmful to other people, should not be allowed. I get that. I'm not opposed to that. But I do think that it's preposterous. You can't buy a small, lightweight, sub $10,000 car because some government bureaucrat thinks it's not safe for you to drive that car. And parenthetically, I think if you got into, let's say, a 1990 model Mercedes S-Class, which would not be in compliance with today's safety mandates, and put it up against a, a brand new Chevy Malibu, which of the two do you think is more survivable if you were to get into a crash? If you said S-Class, go to the head of the class, because yes, indeed, size does matter, but that's a whole nother rant. I won't get into that. Back to the Chinese thing. So as it turns out, guess what they're going to bring to the U.S. market? They're not going to bring the $10,000 cars that this country, this market, hasn't got and desperately needs, in my opinion. Instead, it looks like they're going to bring a bunch of bloated, stupid crossover SUVs. Just what the market needs, eh? More crossover SUVs. I was looking at pictures of one of them. I haven't actually seen one in person yet. And it looks like any other Hyundai, Kia, Nissan, Buick, Chevy, Olds, Ford, whatever you want to call it, another same, mid-sized crossover SUV. Yay. Now, there is some good news here. Because of the lower labor and regulatory costs in China, which is why all manufacturing or a lot of it is being offshored to China, they claim that they're going to be able to sell these vehicles for about 20% less than their U.S. equivalents. And I guess that's good in the sense that you get the price cut, But the downside of it is that a lot of people haven't got the money regardless to buy it because their jobs got offshored to China and now they're working as baristas at Starbucks or greeters at Walmart or something like that where they're making 12 bucks or 15 bucks an hour. And when you're making that kind of money, it's kind of hard to go out and buy a $30,000 or $35,000 crossover SUV. Those people would really benefit from being able to buy a brand new car that could get them from A to B comfortably, and all the rest of it for, I don't know, $8,000, $9,000, $10,000, don't you think so? Plus, it would be a game changer. It would really fundamentally alter the way business is done in this market. It would also at least recoup some of the costs of all this job offshoring, because even if you do work at Starbucks as a barista or a greeter at Walmart, you can probably afford a $10,000 new car. And if you can't afford it new, wait a year or two, and when that same car goes off on the used market, you'll be able to pick it up for $6,000 or $7,000. And anybody who works at Starbucks can afford a car like that. But sadly, we're not going to get that. We're going to get just what the market doesn't need, more overlap, duplicative, pretty much the same as everybody else, except maybe a little bit cheaper, crossover SUVs. Sigh. So, anyway, that's my initial take on this. I'll probably have more up on epautos.com later today. And there's also an article that relates to this about GM's recent slew of layoffs, which is, as it turns out, they're actually getting rid of more workers now than they did back in 08 when the company almost went bankrupt, which is interesting because GM squealed and whined and begged for the government to steal money from the taxpayers to bail it out so that it could save American jobs. Well, guess what? What GM did was take that money, build its business in China, and now that it's healthy again financially and able to pay its top executives and shareholders buttloads of money, it's going to fire those 15,000 American workers, put them out of work, so they can't buy any cars, let alone GM cars, and shuffle off not to Buffalo, but to Beijing, and party, party. So I thought that was pretty obnoxious, and that's why I wrote the rant about that. Anyway, please have a look at both, and leave your comments, let me know what you think, and thanks for viewing, and we will catch up with you again soon.